Kia ora, good morning. Wow, it was quiet so quickly. Welcome to this morning's NCEA Instructional Assembly. Now, before we get into the nuts and bolts of what's going to happen to you people over the next couple of weeks, I'd like to invite one of our special guests to the stage, Mr. Holstein, to address you people. Thank you.
Marina, very nice. Look, I'm barged into this assembly because the real key thing is Mr. Robertson, as he goes through, is your preparation for NCA. But I'm getting fewer and fewer opportunities, one, to speak to our students, and so bear with me today. I realise it's year 12 in front of me, perhaps there's some year 11, but I also know I'm very conscious that the year 11 form classes is being live streamed, so they can get this message as well. So for me, as you're well aware, I'm leaving at the end of the year. And for me, it's quite an emotional time. I made a decision, and I think some people call it a brave one. A lot of people have congratulated me. That's good. Or well, perhaps time for me to go. But I just want to say a huge thank you. And for me, this place will always hold a very special place in my heart. And I've tried over the 8 years that I've been here to create the fact that this is a special school. It's got a very strong history, it's got a great reputation, and that you, as the young people in it, are adding to that. I am constantly impressed by you. And you are the one that gives me the motivation, because you're so much better than certainly I was when I was in your age. So well done to you. Our message at the end of this year is obviously finish strong. And I think I just wanted to share with you a story that I experienced, I've never forgotten. As I went through and listened to this assembly many, many, many years ago, yes, there's the details that you need of getting turning up at the right place at the right time. That's critical for NCA. But it's that time when you leave on study leave between now and those exams are the key thing that I just wanted to just remind you of something that I learned the hard way, is that I took that time lightly, particularly in my final year. I thought I had it under control, but I didn't. And I knew that I hadn't prepared as I should do, because there is time. There certainly is time. And the way you use that time, particularly on your study leave, is the most critical. And some people say, well, it's too late. Definitely not. The way you prioritise, the way you schedule your study, the way you manage your time over this, and your commitment to it. I often say that attitude is your friend. You approach things in a positive way, in a determined way, for just a matter of weeks, it will make the difference at the end. So when you do get the results in January, whereas me, I've never forgotten it when I, in those days it was posted to me, I'd let myself down. I know that you won't let yourselves down. I wish you all the very best as you go through the NCA and beyond. For those of year 12s, enjoy your year 13 year. That's when it all comes together for you. And I think Mr. Robertson, as the senior divisional principal, makes it a very special year for you. For the year 11s moving up to 12, a little bit different as well. And for those leaving Burnside like me, I hope you have fond memories of the school. I leave with an apology. An apology is the fact that our world has changed significantly over the last 2 to 3 years with COVID. And therefore, it's impacted on you like no other students. I just want to say well done to you, the way that you have adjusted, you have modified, you have kept on going and motivated yourself in spite of all that's going on around you. Yes, we can say it's going to make us stronger, but I'm just going to say to you, this isn't what we wanted, but next year, I think when we can park COVID behind a little bit, we'll have our school returning the way it should, and I hope you'll enjoy your experience even more at Burnside High School. All the very best. I'll be keeping an eye on you from afar. Take care. Thank you.
As always, Mr. Holstein, thank you for your words of wisdom. We have another special guest in here this morning, and that is our exam centre manager. Now, Mrs. Jasmine Thompson. Jasmine, just stand up and give a wee wave. Ms. Thompson and her team of exam supervisors will be in charge of you from the day the exams begin. Okay, and I'll talk a little bit more about our expectations of what we want from you during that time. Now, these exams are a step up from our previous school exams and any other assessments that you've done this year. They are run by the national body, NZQA, of course. And with that also comes, I guess, an extra layer of expectations and an extra layer of adherence to their rules to make sure that the results that we get back are authentic and specifically your work. Now, exams can be a bit of a tense time for some people. It's obviously a bit of a nervous time, particularly for our Year 11 people out there who would be the first time through these exams. But I just want to share some good news with you for a start. So, Tech Crew, can we go to slide 2, please? So, on slide 2, there we go. This is looking at our Year 11 results from last year. Okay, so the Year 12 students in front of me, this is what you achieved. And for the Year 11 students who are watching back in your classrooms, this is what I'd like to think that you would be aiming for. And one of the key features of this graph is that we're looking at Burnside High School's achievement over the course of 5 or 6 years. The trend that you can see on there is that there is an increasing gap with Burnside moving further and further ahead, closer and closer to a 90% pass rate. Now that means that the vast majority of our Year 11 students sitting in CEA will pass and get their 80 credits, no problem at all. So for our Year 11 students, there's your goal. For their Year 12 students, well done last year, and this sets a bit of a benchmark for where you people should be going this year. Can we go to slide 3, please? This is my current cohort of Year 13 students and how they performed last year. Okay, now again, you can see that there's a consistent hit rate of, or pass rate of 90% heading through that. So again, there's the benchmark for our level 2 students to be aiming for. Now, this is obviously a collective thing, okay, but it does rely on all of you people performing individually at your best. So I would encourage you to take on Mr. Holstein's pieces of advice, and these days that you've got on your study leave, not holidays, are critical in your preparation for those exams. Now, I've got a few different sections that I want to talk about this morning, and the first is your admission slip. So if we can go to slide 3 or 4, I think, there we go. So at form time last week, you should have received your admission slip from your form teacher. If you haven't got that yet, please touch base with your form teacher in case they have still got them. If they haven't, they will have passed it on to Mrs. Sutton in the assessment office. So you will be able to go and collect that from her. This piece of paper is incredibly important. You will not be allowed into any of your exams unless you have it. Okay, so put it in a safe place. Put it somewhere where you can access it easily. A couple of things about it. The first thing is that you need to check all the details are on there are correct, okay? And the main two things are checking that your name is spelled correctly, which in most cases it will be because it's coming straight out of our database, but then in the odd occasion we get the odd error. Most importantly, however, you need to make sure that your entries are correct on there, okay? So all of your subjects will have entered you for a number of external standards. They should be listed on this piece of paper. If they're not, you will arrive at your exam room and there will be no paper for you. So any papers that you will, or personalised papers that you expect to see in your exam room should be listed on this piece of paper. If you do lose it, okay, you need to reprint your a new sheet yourself. And to get that, you need to go to the NZQA's learner login. All of you should have logged into that by now to make sure that your account is live, and you will be able to print a new copy from there. If you have your own new printed copy, you will need to bring that to Mrs. Sutton in the assessment office, or myself via the student office, and we need to put a signature and a date on it just to say that we have checked it and it is an official copy. You do not write anything on this sheet. Okay, don't write a little list of things to get at the supermarket on the way home, anything like that at all. There is to be no writing on the sheet. Any of the exam supervisors who come along may deem any of the writing that you've got on that piece of paper to be your attempt at cheating. Secondly, make sure you're aware of all of the exam times and dates that are on there. Put those dates into a diary or whatever it is that you use to make sure that you're in the right place at the right time. And the other thing I just had down there was making sure that you have logged into your NZQA learner login account for a start as well. Now, as our Year 12 students have come in here this morning, you've been given a copy of the exam rules and regulations. I'm covering most of the information from that sheet in this presentation this morning. But do have a read through it as well so that you are aware. Year 11 students, I will get a copy of this to your form teachers for tomorrow so that you also have a copy, and this will also be available online. So with your piece of paper, the information online in this assembly this morning, there is no excuse, no way that you can say, oh, I didn't know what the rules were about that, because we will cover everything that you need to know. To slide 5, please. Getting to your exam, the rooming for exams again this year will be in K block, the dance hall, and I block primarily. On our very, very large days, we may have some classrooms which are through into J block. Now, for our Year 12s, just a wee reminder, but for Year 11s, listen very carefully to this piece of information. When we list the rooms on the D block notice board, it's not going to be in the classes that you have had this year. It's not going to be by alphabetical order of your surnames. What you will find on your admission slip is a four-digit or four-character code, such as M168, as you can see on here. The exam rooming is via alphabetical order of that exam code. All right, so that is your specific code for our school for the duration of these exams. So when you go to the board and see the rooms listed, you're not going to see a list of names next to it. You're going to see a span of exam centre codes which are on there. Okay, so the exam rooming will also be available online, and once again, we will share a link with you later this week, which you will have to go to and find your rooms for that. When you come to these school NCEA exams, you should be in school uniform. All right, this includes times that you are coming into school for tutorials. Maybe some of your teachers have arranged some study sessions and so forth. Any of our Year 11 and 12 students, we want to see you in uniform. All right, part of the reason for that is that other students and other schools recognise how good we are and try and sneak into our school and do some work in our library as well. We want to keep those people out. When you arrive at your exam room, can you please make sure you arrive at least 20 minutes prior to the start time? So the morning exam sessions, they begin at 9:30, which means you will arrive there at 10 past 9. The afternoon session will begin at 2 p.m, which means that you will arrive there at 1:40 p.m. at the latest. All right, so building that little bit of a buffer in time to make sure that you are there plenty of time means that you are able to go into the room relaxed. You're not rushing around trying to find the room and then getting in there late and disturbing other people. So 20 minutes, and then even if you are a little bit late, you should be able to get into that exam just fine. If you are late for the exam, you must be within the first 30 minutes, okay? And anything after that, you will not be granted admission to that. So once you're in the exam, you can't leave within the first 45 minutes, although I wouldn't see why you would want to do that anyway. Once you're in the exam, you also get into the last 15 minutes of that 3 hours. You cannot leave then either. If you do come into the exam room late, you will be given a written copy of any previous instructions or some form of information to give you any instructions. But my best advice for you in this situation is just plan not to be late. Get there on time. The seating is done, as I mentioned before, by your exam code. So that means there's a little bit of work to be done by the supervisors. Now, our supervisors, we've got a great team of people who come in here. The majority of them have been here previous years as well, so they know exactly what they're doing. It is really important that you listen to the exam supervisors and follow all of their instructions. Okay, so many of these people, they're not actually teachers at the school at this point of time. Some may be relief teachers, some may be have been teachers in the past and have now retired and have just come in to do this. They are employed by NZQA to run these exams, and therefore they, rather than us as a school, are in charge of what is happening in there. And we request for that is, so like, you know, in I Block where there's that large foyer outside, both upstairs and down, okay, on our big exam days, that means that there's going to be six rooms worth of students outside in that foyer area. My request here is that you are quiet at that time. Once the supervisors come to try come to seat you in your rooms in the correct order, it only takes a few people to have a few little quiet conversations amongst that big crowd of people, and it becomes a big noise. Okay, and a few people talking is a signal that other people can talk as well. So when the supervisors say to be quiet, everyone is quiet. Okay, and then we can get on with that process of rooming people much quicker. Take all necessary equipment into the room with you. And a reminder that for these exams, pencil cases are not cool. We need to have all of your stuff in a clear plastic bag so that we can see that nothing illegal is being brought into those exams. Calculators, you are allowed a maximum of two calculators in there. There is an approved calculator list for certain subjects, such as your science and maths subjects, but they will be checked by some of our staff who will come around and ask you to clear the memory and so forth on those. Don't bring into the exam any other electronic devices with any capability to store information or communicate or retrieve data. Cell phones, likewise, must be turned off and on the floor, okay, not sitting in your pocket on silent. Okay, so when you go into your exam room, switch it off and put it on the floor. Don't bring any other paper into exams. You might have some study notes or bits and pieces. It would be acceptable to leave them at the front of the room, but do not take them in there. Do not have any written notes or anything on your hands or arms. It might sound a little bit silly, but we had one chap one year who had almost a complete essay written on his thigh, which he referred to during the exam. Do not bring any headphones into the exam. I know we've got lots of little earbuds and things like that which can just slip in there nice and easily, but you will leave those at home for the day. Don't bring any form of digital dictionary, and once again, of course, electronic or any watches are banned from there, from coming into the exams. You are able to bring into the exams an emergency pack, which again, like your cell phone, will go on the floor under your chair. Things like your keys, emergency money, or anything like that can be stored in that. I've been asked in previous years about taking a drink into the exam. Yes, you can take a drink. You can take water in a clear, unlabeled bottle. Taking snacks into the exam, the answer to that is no, unless perhaps you're maybe like diabetic or something like that, and you've come to see Mrs. Sutton or myself just to notify us of your situation, and we are aware of that. During the exam, so you've got yourself to the room, you've got into the room, the supervisors have got you sitting in the right place. Can you make sure that once you've sat down that you have the correct set of booklets? Now, you'll find on your exam booklet, it's not going to have your name printed on there. Your name, for as far as NZQA is concerned, is a 9-digit number known as your NSN number. So your first job once you sit down is to grab your admission slip, match it up with the NSN numbers which are printed on each of your exam booklets. If they do not match, let your supervisor know immediately. It's not unusual, or it hasn't been unusual in the past, to find that a student who's been away and left a gap in the seating, and then a student sat in the wrong seat and actually earned a couple of merits and excellence for the student who was away and missed that. That wasn't picked up until after the exams had been marked and results came back the following year, so make sure you've got the right set of papers. Once again, listen to all of the instructions of the exam supervisor as they start the exam, and next thing, only write on papers that you want marked. So if you've strategically made a decision to not sit a particular paper, or there's been some arrangement with your teacher and your parents that you're going to leave that standard out, don't write anything on it at all. A single word in question one would deem your attempt to answer that paper, which would result in a not achieved as opposed to a standard not attempted. For your exams, do not use pencil, red or green pen, or any form of correction fluids. Only use blue and black pen, okay? And that's because red and green are used for marking and check marking purposes. If you were to use a red or green pen, your information might be marked. However, it might not be as well, and you have no grounds to come back to appeal any of your grades if you have done that. Please make sure at the end of any exam session you hand in all of your materials as well. And once again, we've had people who have walked out with a piece of with an exam book that they've actually written an answer into. Once it leaves the room, it is void and can no longer be marked. So check before you've left the room that you have handed in any of the material that you need marked. If you've used extra paper, make sure you've written your NSN code on the top of that as well. Now, we get very few, if any, of these situations each year, and that is a breach of exam conditions. Now, by the time you people have got to year 11 and 12, we thank you for the way that you've got yourselves into the groove of things and are aware of what expectations are around exams. If you do try to talk or cheat or communicate with other students in the room or cause any form of disruption, you'll simply be removed and your papers will not be marked. A report is written on what has happened and it gets sent to me and it gets sent to NZQA in Wellington. Okay, so I just need to say that to make sure that you are aware of what the processes will be should you put yourself in that position, but I trust that will not happen. After the exam, it is expected that you leave the school grounds. Okay, we've still got junior classes running here, and unless, like I mentioned before, you are attending like a tutorial or something with your teachers, you are either at home on study leave or you are at school sitting an exam. Sitting around having lunch at school, we kind of don't want to see that at the moment while we manage the year 9s and 10s here at the same time. The next thing, if you miss an exam or you have an impaired performance through some emergency event or COVID-19 gets in the way, the first thing is we need to get some documentation around that. So in most cases, it is a medical certificate. Unfortunately, there is a bereavement or the like in your family, we need to get some documentation of that. And then there is a process that we put into place for you called the unexpected event grade. This is perhaps formally known as a derived grade or a number of other things as well. But there's an application that we need to go through for in order to be able to use that grade. We, as a school, don't get to decide whether your situation is approved or not. We just enter the information and that is decided by a panel in Wellington. If there is an accident on the morning, again, you need to see us immediately and we can put some documentation in place for that. If you are unsure, then I guess my key bit of advice there is to email Ms. Sutton and to see if she can give you some sort of advice around that. The one thing we cannot use for a derived grade is if you turn up late for the exam, or forget, or thought it was in the afternoon when it was in fact in the morning or on a different day, we cannot use your emergency grade in that case. If you forget your exam, you do not get another opportunity. Next thing, around your results. These will be made available around the early to middle of January. All results are now available online, so once again, it is important that you have logged into NZQA, you have your learner login sorted, and are able to access these. A wee bit later in January, you will also be able to access via that learner login your a scanned copy of your exam papers so that you can see exactly where your grades have been earned. And at that point, I guess, as well, you should be able to see if you want to appeal any of those grades or marking at the same time. A couple of important things about results, and particularly for Year 12 people here, this year's results are important. Now, I know you're coming back to do Level 3 next year in most cases. However, the Level 2 results you get, and also from these external exams, will be the only external results you have when you come to apply for things like scholarships and halls of residence applications for next year. Okay, so your Level 2 results are what we deal with in a number of situations for next year. They are also important because, and if you check on back with your course documentation, a lot of those standards may count towards your UE literacy. Okay, so you need 5 reading and 5 writing credits for university entrance literacy. So if you, the more you can get this year, just takes a bit of pressure off and any restrictions around subject choices for next year. Finally, if we go to slide 7 there, please. So there's the Mrs. Sutton's email address, so assessment@burnside.school.nz. I also get any of those emails that come through to that, so any queries you can go to there. And last slide, so the last one. Like Mr. Holstein said, it is important with these exams that you do prepare well. He often refers to this thing called delayed gratification. And what that means is that, you know, over this next wee bit, and it's an awful time of year to have to sit exams. You would have seen as you arrived in here this morning, the weather out there is beautiful, okay? And as a school, we're now asking you to go home and sit down and study and prepare yourself for these exams. The payoff for that is just taking those few more weeks to make sure that you have prepared yourself to get the best results that you are capable of, rather than the result that you get on the day just by showing up and hoping for the best of luck, is a big difference. So we are asking you to just make sure that you put in that bit of effort over the next 4 or 5 weeks so that you are happy with the results. Next, look after yourself around these times, and there has been a little bit of a surge of COVID again. I still believe that, you know, your results that you are going to be able to achieve on the day will be better than any exam results that you would have got back in our September exams. So keep yourself healthy, make sure you get plenty of sleep, and, you know, that whole balanced lifestyle of getting enough exercise and things really does pay off as well. Okay, and finally, kia kaha tō mahi. Just make sure that you do get stuck in and to these exams and earn the best results that you possibly can. Now, as far as that goes, that's probably about it. Any of the additional information that you require, you can go back to the sheet that I've given you now. For the live stream going to Year 11 classes, so Tech Crew, we can finish that, and Year 12, I'm just going to get you to stay for a couple more minutes. We've got just a couple more short announcements.